guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh Lord, some of these days I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother howdy.
Right in ourselves. Yeah. Neither decline from the word. Thank you. still be rejoicing and be glad in it. From the 140th song to the 150th song, each one begins with praise the Lord. Then each one ends with praise the Lord. Then that 150th song said, everything that had breath ought to do what? Praise the Lord. And we can say in all the yellow lines to see each other's faith, we ought to do what? Praise the Lord. We praise the Lord from which all our blessings come. So this morning, my brothers and sisters, and to this very family, to all who have gathered here today in this homegoing service of Mr. Anthony and the kid is Whitehead. The family has sat down and put this program together. And I see on this program, he says, THE, Order of Service. Gwen and some of the rest of us, we were taught by William Andrews, and we were taught that when the word the, when a consonant precedes the word the, you say it the. But when a vowel precedes the word the, we say the. So the family had put the order of service together. And the order of service, our order is a command. And the order of service they have put together, we are commanded by the family to do just what they have ordered. Amen? Amen. For the order is put together, and I don't have to say another word. I can go over here and sit, and the order of service which family had put together, we follow in their order. Amen.
Yeah.
Father, we know that you're a good God. And it reads, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make it boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all my fears. They looked to him and were radiant, and their faces were not ashamed. The poor man cried out, and the Lord heard him, and saved him out of all of his trouble. The angels of the Lord encamp all around those who fear him and deliver them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord. 8 verses of the 34th Psalm.
Yes, sir. Verses 4 through 8. And it reads as follows. It says, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. It says, let your gentleness be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. And he goes on to tell us, be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. He goes on to tell us, finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are good report, if there are any virtue, if there is anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things. The things which you've learned and received and heard and saw in me, these do. And the God of peace will be with you. It is the word of God for the people of God.
Just what I'm to the ministers of the gospel, Marie family, and all of you who have come today to share in a homegoing celebration of Nikki. That's what we have known ever since he was born. Today, I will just give you and reflect on Nikki's life. From a kid to an adult, Nikki registered in school at the age of 5. Out of 41 kids, he was a third of his class. He was one of the highest in his class. Smaller than the other kids, but smarter than some of the other kids. No junior first grade for Nikki. Thanks to a strong mom and a praying mother, Nikki was always well-mannered. He was just like some of the other kids, run down the hall, hide in the bathroom, but he focused on his studies. Report cards at that time was S for satisfaction, U for unsatisfaction, N for need improvement. Nikki always got S's, which was satisfactory. In middle school, it was A, B, C, D, and F. He always made A's and B's. Nikki was a flag kid. Each day, his responsibility was to put up the flag on the flagpole. He knew what the colors meant. He knew what the stars meant. He knew that the flag should never touch the ground. Many of us don't know that today. In high school, he graduated with honors. He continued his education by attending Georgia Southwestern University, receiving a musical scholarship. He received many awards and recognitions on his job at H&R Block, Mercy, Eckers Corporation, and many other employments. He always did what was asked of him and some extra, and helping others as well. Always caring and respectful to adults. Nick received his last promotion on Friday, October the 27th at 10:36. God wanted a hard-fighting soldier. God wanted a hard worker. He fought a good fight in life. He has finished the race. He has been called to be promoted and to receive his crown. His crown of life and promoted to his eternal home. Nikki's grandparents, his uncles, his cousin, and his nephew, they would always welcome him as they see him. They are waiting at the gate to welcome him with open arms. Nikki, you can dance. You can walk around heaven all day when you wake up in the morning. Don't worry about your family down here. Virgil will take care of your mom as he took care of you for 22 years. We hope to see and meet you again on that other show. See you later, Nikki. We love you.
I heard someone get put a little bird in my ear. He was a Kansas spiritual friend. Now I'm gonna try to do this song, but y'all gonna have to help me. Is that alright? Now we're gonna take it by just a little bit. That's okay. We just go. go back a little bit. I know we got contemporary. We just gonna put some hand clapping, a little feet stomping, let's have a good time. Is that all right? Y'all act like you wanna have a good time with me. Come on now.
They moved to Hawaii. Gwen got a job. And my daddy told her to bring him back. He was the first grandchild. Bring him back and let us see by the washing word. When she brought him back, me and Babe was the youngest born. He was just like our little brother. We used to eat him up. I told him as life went on, I wish I had an H of them. But I thank God for it, and I thank God for my sister,
amen,
who has really been strong through it all.
Amen.
I thank God for it. Coming on up, when Nikki went to school, Nikki had some friends. They were called the Heartbeats. I don't know how many of them it was, but they were the Heartbeats. It was the Heartbeat. And Quinn always said, I don't know whether a lot of you remember this, the store called Young World. Young World was an expensive children's clothing store. And Quinn said, you know, I just get out of the clothes in Young World, because Nick was the best dressed man at school. I said, okay. One of my friends sent me a picture with Nick and some more of the Heartbeats on there. Nick had on some hot water jeans. Nick had on some white tennis shoes. Nick had on a muscle shirt. And I sent the picture to her. She said, who did you tell me? He had a red, a purple and white striped shirt and went right with that shirt right there. She had some for everything. She had some for everything, y'all. Nicky came on up. Nicky graduated from high school on his senior trip. Gwen was living in Miami. He took his friend to Miami with him, stayed a week with Gwen. She took him everywhere she went, y'all. Everywhere she went. Finally, Melvin went out there. Him and Nicky went out there and got an apartment together. Gwen called Melvin, mama said, you need to come get him. I got another one. Came over, he had Kyra. Nick was about 17 to 18 years old in Kyra, so Kyra was more like a brother to him. So they did a lot of things together, and he could eat him. Because Gwen got Kyra, took him to Miami, just like she did Nick and Shusha, like sisters and brothers. We're coming on up to that, y'all. After all of that, my mind is trying to leave me, but devil, you're not going to take this from me today. Some things that I got to say. Came on up, next was Nikiri. His daughter, Nikiri. Nikiri said, Gwen, Ben's going to come down here. Don't forget now, you got to send Nikiri casserole or somebody. Gwen said, that's your daughter, your granddaughter, you send them something. We get ready to go home. Gwen got this big old thing. I had to get a truck to bring a table, a chair, and stuff like that. Ben, take this Nikiri casserole. You ought to stop talking about what you ain't gonna do, how you know you're gonna do it. You ain't warmed up to Navi. Navi, y'all nigga could eat Navi. Navi was allergic to eggs. Every time I go to Florida, I have a bag of stuff. As a little boy, nigga said, people, you know Navi can't eat eggs now. I read on the Kit Kat paper, I had Kit Kat. That's the only thing I know that didn't have eggs in. So every time I went, I took Navi Kit Kat. Hey, nigga and them was in the house together with Gwen. Bae said, Nikki came in one morning and said, Bae, what you cooking? Nava had scrambled eggs. He said, you know, Nava can't have no eggs. Bae said, I'm cooking scrambled egg, fried egg, boiled egg. But that egg, they was cooking. The boys up there. She just said, Julie, she didn't get no egg for real now. Just last Saturday, I asked Louise, I said, Louise, we were reminiscing on Nikki. I said, you know what? Nikki used to call all of us girls. All this not to you, he said, good, what you got for me, good? What's going on? I said, boy, well, he know I'm a real man. He knew. He knew I'm a real man, y'all. And Virgil asked my daddy 22 years ago, could he marry Gwen? I said, who do that, dad? You should have to ask Mary. My daddy said, I got some old daughters, if you want out with me. Virgil told me, he said, you know, Nick was something else. He said he was always calling me boss because Virgil had a business. But when he wanted something, he'll say, Dad. So Virgil knew the difference too. I was just trying to reminisce on a few things that he said. When Sister Libby's song, Hello, mother, I made it over. And about the heavenly choir, my nephew called me the other night and he said, Penny, Auntie Penny, my fondest memory of Nicky was we used to always give bikes to school parties. And it was at my house one time, it was at my sister-in-law's house one time, and he said, that Nicky freak know they song. He said, they song. He said, they were lit and the girls were hollering. I said, that freak probably song, I don't know about Nicky. All Nicky did was climb. From y'all being here today, I want to thank y'all from the Whitehead family, from the Purvis family, and from the Kimball family. I know that y'all love the Nicky the same way we did. Yeah. Nicky had a friend in Florida named Dorian. Dorian had a moving company. Nicky go work when he get ready. Nicky wouldn't work when he get ready. Dorian always, you know, he told me today he came from Florida for the film, and him and Dante and Dino, I think. All of them. They came for the family. And he shared with me just this morning. He said, Nicky had a heart of gold. He said he was a real gentleman. He loved him. And I appreciate y'all for that. I appreciate everybody, my extended family, everybody. Everybody who came out today to be with us. Gwen always said to my dad was the oldest of 18. Gwen always said, you know, I'm the older grandchild. Nicky the older great-grandchild. Kyle the older great-great-grandchild. She said, put on that line. Dad, we all know it. I want to say thank you for coming to share this day with us. This week has really been hard, but we made it through. Before I take my seat, I just want to read a poem for you. It's called The Dash. I read of a woman who stood to speak at the funeral of a nephew and a friend. She referred to the dates on his tombstone from the beginning to the end. She noted that first came the date of his birth, and she spoke the following day with tears. She said, what mattered most of all was the dash between those years. For that dash represent all the time that was spent alive on earth. And only those who loved him knew what that little line is worth. For it mattered how much, it doesn't matter how much we own, the house, the cars, the cash. What matters is how we live in love and how we spend our dash. So think about this moment hard. Are there things you'd like to change? For you never know how much time is left. You could be at that mid-range. Amen. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true and real, and always try to understand the way other people feel. Be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our life like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remember that that little dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life action to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? Before I take my seat, I want to share one more thing. I asked Mike Whitehead, I said, Mike, do you have anything that you remember about Nicky that was funny because we want to be uplifting, we don't want to be sad. And this is what he told me, and it did my heart so good. He said 3 weeks ago, Nicky texted him, I left a message on his phone and said, Daddy, I love you. And to me, that just meant so much, right? Yes. Thank you for who you are. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
He also says that he follows up our tears in every tear that we suffer, that we will reap in joy. And on behalf of the class of 1990 of America High School, I'm going to share two quick things about Nicky, and then I'll be a point that I have right, and I'm going to share it with his mom and give it to her once I'm done. Two quick things. One thing, I used to work at Magnolia Manor when I was in high school, and Nicky's grandmom was there, Miss Kimball. I think that was the grandmom, Miss Kimball. And she said, you know my grandbaby Nicky? And of course I did, there's only one Nicky right here. But she was so sweet, and she would always ask me, how's Nicky doing? You know Nicky? Or I don't know if she would forgive me. Yes, ma'am, I did. But I remember when Nicky came to Sarah Hall, fifth grade. It was Miss Midland's class, Tasha Evans, Tawanda, myself, I can't remember all of the other classmates, but he came in and we were all like, who is that tall black boy? And I'm like, no, Tasha. And I just wanted to make it bounce. But it was like, that tall black boy. But anyway, he will definitely be missed, and we love you all so much, and you will definitely be in our thoughts and prayers. But the title of the poem is Just For Today. Just for today, I will try to live through the next 24 hours and not expect to get over my child's death, but instead learn to live with it just one day at a time. Just for today, I will remember my child's life, not his death, and bask in the comfort of all those treasured days and moments we shared. Just for today, I will forgive all the family and friends who didn't help or comfort me the way I needed them to. They truly did not know how. Just for today, I will smile no matter how much I hurt on the inside. For maybe if I smile a little, my heart will soften and I will begin to heal. Just for today, I will free myself from my self-inflicted burden of guilt. For deep in my heart, I know if there was anything in this world I could have done to save my child from death, I would have done it. Just for today, I will honor my child's memory by doing something with another child, be it my own or someone else, because I know that would make my child proud. Just for today, I will offer my hand in friendship to another bereaved parent, for I do know how they feel. Just for today, I will allow myself to be happy and enjoy myself, for I know that I am not deserting him by living on. Just for today, I will remember that even death cannot take away the special love we shared. And just for today, I will accept that I did not die when my child did. My life did go on, and I am the only one who can make life worthwhile once more. And the author of that poem is unknown, but the scripture that I'm going to read is 2 Corinthians, the first chapter, the 3rd through 4th verses. It says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our afflictions, so that we may be able to comfort those who are in any affliction with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted by God. And again, that's 2 Corinthians, the first chapter, verses 3 through 4. And this is in loving memory of our classmate, Nikki Whitehead, Americus High School, class of 1990.
Close. assembly. I greet you in the name of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. This is a homegoing celebration. Amen. Cousin Penny asked me yesterday, is there a story that you want to share about you and Nikki? I said it wouldn't be appropriate for a church setting. Amen. We ran the streets, and one thing I can say, we did what we wanted to do, and we enjoyed what we did. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Though the storms keep on raging in my life, and sometimes it's hard to tell the night from day, still that hope that lies within is reassured as I keep mine eyes upon the distant shore. I know you'll lead me safely to that blessed place He has prepared. But if the storms don't cease, and if the wind keep on blowing in my life, my soul has been, everybody say, to tell the nights from day. Still that hope that lies within is reassured as I keep mine eyes upon the distant shore. I know you'll be saved to that blessed place He has prepared. But if the storms don't cease, just in case the wind keeps on blowing in my life, my soul, everybody say, anchored in the Lord. Lord, I sometimes, in this life, you're gonna be tossed by the winds and the currents seem so fierce sometimes, but in the Word of God, I've got an anchor, yes I do, and it keeps me steadfast, unmovable, despite the times. But if the storms don't cease, just in case the wind keeps on blowing in my life, my soul has been, everybody say, anchored in the Lord. Oh, thank you.
does not matter what it feels like. You got to know that you're anchored in God. And when you're anchored in God, let the winds blow. Let the storm rise. Come on, you got to know. My soul has been anchored. My soul has been anchored. My soul has been anchored. My soul, tell your neighbor. My soul is, come on, y'all do it. My soul has been anchored. My soul has been anchored. My soul has been anchored. Bullets may roll, breakers may dash. I will not swim because he holds me fast. Dark is the night, clouds in the sky. I know it's alright, cause Jesus is mine. My soul has been anchored. My soul has been anchored. My soul has been anchored. My soul is, my soul has been, everybody say, anchored in the Lord. Come on, if he's been anchored, come on, you want to open up your mouth? Come on, tears and God's. Come on, I want you to do me one favor. Can we give a standing ovation? So much to so many people. Amen. I don't want to stand before you long, but 2 Samuel chapter 12, verse number 20. The Bible reads, then David got up from the ground after he had washed, put on a fresh change of clothes. He went into the house of the Lord and he worshiped. Then went to his own house, and at his request, they served him food, and he ate. I want to preach for a moment from a subject I still got a reason. Come on, tap to somebody and tell them I still got a reason. Now, this word reason is defined as the fact that explains something, why something is done. In the text, David is dealing with grief, just like all of us are today. His son is sick and at the point of death. He's not eating. He's not talking to anybody. He ain't bathing. The king is grieving. Just like many of us, David is dealing with grief the best way he knows how. That was a study that was done on the different stages of grief. The first stage is denial. This is the numbness of carrying on as if nothing has happened. Even if we know a loved one has died and it's hard to believe that they're not coming back. Somebody say denial. We say it in our culture, it ain't hit me yet. So there's a denial. The second emotion is anger. Death can seem cruel and unfair, especially when you feel someone has died before that time or you had plans for the future together. It's also common to feel angry towards ourselves for things we did or did not do before their death. That's the third one, bargaining. All right. When we are in pain, it's sometimes hard to accept that there's nothing we can do to change things. Bargaining is when you start to make deals with ourselves, perhaps with God also. Bargaining, watch this, is have you ever been in a position or a condition where you were drunk or high? Let me talk to the folks in the back. And you said, God, if you get me through this, I wish I could talk to a real church in here. Come on, I'm talking about with your head on the commode and get me through this. I never drunk. next weekend, we turn it up again. That's what you call bargaining with God. It's also common, watch this, to find ourselves going over things that happened in the past and asking a lot of what if questions. Wishing we could go back and change things in hope things could have turned out differently. Somebody said bargaining. There's the fourth one, that's depression. Depression is sadness and longing, or what we think of most often when we think about grief. This pain can be very intense and come in waves over many months or years. Life can feel like it no longer has any meaning. Depression. There's the last one, which is acceptance. Grief comes in waves, and it can feel like nothing will ever be right again. But gradually, most people find that pain will ease. And it is possible, watch this, to accept what has happened. We may never get over the death of someone, but we can learn to live again while keeping the memory of those we have lost close to our hearts. Can I work the text?
Yes,
David, watch this, hears his servants whispering about his son. And David realized, my son has died. And what we find in the text, after he finds out his son has died, he gets up from the ground. And he washes his face, he changes his clothes, and he goes into the house of God. Again, I wish I could preach this thing like I feel it. He goes into the house of God. This doesn't make any sense to his servants. Why would you want to praise God after your son has died? To some, this may look like I'm praising God because he died. What David is doing is demonstrating the grief of acceptance. He's decided, watch this, to praise him not for his death, but in spite of his death. This is a characteristic that's not prevented by external situation. Some of you may be hurting right now, but you still got a praise in your mouth. Some of you may be angry right now, but you still got a praise in your mouth. I may not understand it, and my heart may be broken, but God said, let everything. I wish I had a church in here. Let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. This is the same David who lost his child that said in Psalms 34, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Oh, magnify the Lord. Tell your neighbor and say, me, magnify. That means make him big. Don't sit on him. Magnify him. The Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Do me one more favor. I know we had a funeral, but it's a homegoing celebration. Chat somebody and say, neighbor, I will. Y'all ain't touching nobody. I know we got COVID. Just give them a high five in the air and say, neighbor, I will bless the Lord at all times. Praises shall. When I'm broke, I'll praise him. When I'm up, I'll praise him. Bills are due. Don't know where the money coming. I'll praise him. Let everything that has work. Praise you the Lord. Watch this, watch this. Don't sit down.
not predicated upon what's going on around me. And this emotion is joy. Somebody shout joy. Yes, sir, I feel my help coming now. Joy. Now watch this. Because I grew up in an old sanctified church. And I remember the mothers used to say, this joy that I have, the world didn't give it. And the world showed up, can't take it away. Believe me, y'all, I got to get out of here. But weeping may, I said weeping may, endure for a night. But joy comes in the morning. Somebody shout, yeah, yeah. Yes, sir. Somebody shout joy. Come on, God is getting ready to give you laughter for your morning. God is getting ready to give you beauty for your ashes. Yea, though, come out, David. Yea, though, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Somebody ought to stand up and sit right now and say, I got John. 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 I'm trying to get out of here, y'all. But would you look at somebody and say, I still got a reason. I may not feel like it. It may not look like it. But I will bless his name because he's good in the morning. He's good in the evening. He's good. I got a reason. I got a reason. Go ahead and high five everybody around me. And say, I got a reason. I got a reason. The Bible says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All ye lands. You want to confuse your enemies. They want you to be depressed. They want you to give up. They want you to go in the tower. But we're nothing about the goodness of Jesus. At all, he done for me.
Thank you. go. I have so many things to see and do. You must tie yourself to me with tears. Be happy that we had these years. I gave you my love, and you can only guess how much you gave me in happiness. I thank you for the love that you each have shown. For now it is time that I travel alone. So grieve a while, and grieve you must. Then let your grief be comforted by trust. It's only for a while that we must part. So bless the memories within your heart. I won't be far away, for life goes on. So if you need me, come and I will come. Though you can't see or touch me, I'll be here. And if you listen with your heart, you'll hear my love around you, so soft and so clear. And then when you too must travel this way alone, I'll reach you with a smile and say welcome home. The family of Mr. Arthur and Lee Whitehead is most appreciative for the many kind and loving expressions of sympathy that you each have shown. They have prayed to you prayers for days to come, and may each of you continue the blessings of the Lord. The following four arrangements and resolutions have been given to the family. Resolution in loving memory of Brother Arthur Whitehead. We, the members of the Anointed Life Ministry of Plain City, Incorporated, desire to express our deepest condolences to the family members of our dearly beloved brother, Arthur Nicky Whitehead. Because our God, whose mercy endures forever, has taken from this earthly tabernacle one of his loyal and faithful servants to his eternal life in the Lord Jesus Christ. Whereas our beloved brother, Arthur Nicky Whitehead, shall no longer forbear nor suffer the pains, sufferings, and cares of this earthly tabernacle, hear ye the words of God. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is death. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Henceforth, be it resolved that we embrace and mourn with the family of our dearly beloved brother, Arthur Nicky Whitehead. Let a copy of this resolution be given unto the family in a copy file at the Anointed Life Ministry of Plant City, Incorporated. Humbly submitted, Pastor Elder Lloyd McDonald, co-pastor, Elder Yvonne McDonald. Church family, Americus, Georgia, in loving memory of Mr. Arthur.